Hello everyone. In this video, we'll see the convolution neural network, or it is called as the CNN. So in this video, we are going to see the introduction of the CNN. In that, we'll see the architecture of the CNN, why the CNN is important, what is the motivation of the CNN, and its applications. So basically, convolution neural network are the specialized kind of neural network. Specialized kind of neural network is different than your normal neural network or traditional neural network. In traditional neural network, we are extracting the features explicitly or out of the network, and then after extracting the features, we are used to apply the features for the classification. So traditional neural network does the classification work while features are extracted separately. In case of the CNN, both the parts, that is the feature extraction as well as the classification, both the things are done in the network itself. So that's why it is called as the convolution neural network, because the features are extracted by the process of convolution. CNN are kind of neural network which are designed from the biological driven model. So basically, these are derived from the how the BNN works, or the biological neural network works. So basically, the researchers has think that the how the human perceives the image into the different layers of the brain. So what are the images perceived by the human being? So these are perceived in the different layers of the brain, or the different parts of the brain. So there are the various parts in which the different informations are perceived or the process. So in the same way, we are not extracting the features separately. Whenever we see the any image, directly we can detect that image or detect that object. How it is possible by the human being? In the same way that CNNs are designed. So that's why it is designed from the biological driven model. It is very efficient in image processing as well as pattern recognition application. So wherever the image processing part is coming, or the pattern recognition or the object recognition type of applications are important or the required, in that case CNNs are very very efficient one. Its purpose is to detect what the object and where the object is present in the scene. So what the object means, we have to detect the object itself, what is the name of the object, along with that where the object is present. So that is the location of the object within that scene. At the same time, sometimes we are calculating the values of this object. What are the application of this CNN? Wherever the camera is present, the CNN is useful for the pattern recognition. So if you see a human being, so human beings eyes are working as the camera, and whenever the we are perceiving the certain images or certain object, so eyes are taking the picture of this object, and directly we can recognize this object or the detect that object, and along with that we can detect the location of this object itself. So then the most of the processes, or we can say our actions, are depends upon the eyes, because there is the feedback from the eyes. Eyes sees the scene or the object, and these are detected, and according to the detected object we are taking the action. So all the actions for the human being, all the actions are mostly depends upon the our eyes input, or what the eyes sees, and according to that other body organs are taking the action. So camera is the very important. So whenever you want to design the any system to perceive the something, and after perceiving, depends upon the perception, we can take the certain action. So in that case the camera is required, and in wherever the camera is found in any application, we require the CNN for the pattern recognition. Such applications may be the mobile phones. In mobile phones, we can develop the application as the gesture control for controlling the certain, you can say the operations of the mobile phone. Maybe this something of the sliding the tab, or maybe the deleting the something from the mobile, or maybe switching on and switching off the mobile, or making the something on from the mobile. Maybe the camera is made on by certain gesture. So we can recognize the gesture, hand, maybe the hand gestures, or maybe the body gestures, or maybe the eyeball positions. Based upon that gesture, we can control the various operations of your mobile phone. In surveillance also we can use the CNN, because in that surveillance we are always detecting the object. So object may be the any animal or anything, may be the planes of the or fighter planes of the enemies, or maybe the people detection which are entering into the subway tunnel, who is entering into the subway tunnel, who is exit from the subway tunnel, how many number of people exit, how many number of people entered into the subway tunnel. So all these applications are related to the surveillance. In automotive, there may be the driverless car. So in driverless cars, normally your car is detecting the object. So object may be the pedestrian on the road, or it may be the something speed breakers, or maybe the any obstacles on the road, or it may be the line which are black and white lines which are present on the road. And according to that, we can take the driverless car can take the action. So basic thing is here the object detection. Along with that, not the fully driverless car, it may be the driver assistant. So sometimes the what are the turnings that we can, or the some sign, road signs that can be detected by the our system by using the CNN, and that may be helpful or maybe the assistance for the driver. So that type of application we can design by using the CNN. Natural language processing, this is the one of the important application of the CNN. In natural language processing, we require to recognize the characters. So first the characters are recognized as the object. Once the character is recognized, after that we can form the certain words. Once the words are formed, we can form the certain sentences, and then we can, by using the your semantic or the syntactic analysis, we can get the meaning of that sentence. So in that way we can recognize or we can process our natural language. There are the certain application which are used in case of the artificial intelligence. So in almost all the application we require to use the CNN, which is mostly very efficient for all this application or the many type of applications. So this is the architecture of CNN. So basically the before going for the CNN architecture, normally the CNNs are used for the image processing part or the image processing application or the object detection in the any image. So this image is normally represented as a matrix. So it has the x coordinates, y coordinates. Along with that x and y coordinates, there are the pixels. So number of pixels depends upon the number of rows, number of columns. So according to that row into columns, we'll get the number of pixels, or there is a large number of pixel or the matrix of the pixels in case of the any image. And within that pixels, x and y coordinates of that particular pixel is there, and these are the values of the pixel. So xy coordinates, that is the location of the pixel or spatial location of the pixel. Along with that, what is the value of the pixel, that is image intensity in case of the gray scale images. So these are the values. That values may be in case of the black and white image, this may be the 0 and 1. So 0 corresponding to the black, 1 corresponding to white, or maybe the vice versa in some cases. Or if it is the gray level image, and if it is the converted into digital one, by using the 8-bit, in that case these values may be ranging from the 0 to 255. So according to that, each and every pixel has a certain value, its location as per its x and y coordinates, and its corresponding value of the pixel, which indicates the its intensity or brightness. So this is the small portion of the some image. Within this portion, we are processing the image in terms of the small patch, or we can say this is the kernel. So by using the some kernel or the some filters, so there may be the different types of filter, maybe the low pass filter, high pass filter, or maybe the different types of filter, depends upon the which information you want to extract by using this particular filter. So this is the 3x3 filter. It's within that 3x3 filter, what are the values of the component or the weight values of this filter 3x3, all the 9 values, what is that values according to that this filter may be the low pass, high pass, or there may be the number of filters. So that filters we are going to place on the our image, some part of the image, not the whole image. Then this is initially placed at this position 3x3, so 9 component, and these are convolved with each and every component. So the component of the filter or the kernel, each and every component is convolved with each and every component of the image within this 3x3 square. So within with this one, you are going to convolve. So this pixel value, original pixel values are converted into the some another value. So it is a one value of the pixel. Then if you are using the more, because single filter will not work, you have to extract the number of information or different information from the image. So you are going to use the number of filters. So how many number of filters you are using, according to that there will be n number of layers will be generated. So from the image, how many number of filters you are using, so one filter will generate the one plane or the layer, another filter which get the different information than this filter will give the another layer. So in that way, we are stacking all the output layers, which will give you the depth of this one. So width of this output, height of this one, along with that we are getting the depth. So depth is depends upon the number of filters, how many filters we are using. So this convolution layer will convolve the filter with a pixel of the original image one by one. So this will be sliding over this one, and we are getting the resultant output. Along with that, we are going to use the one activation function. So output of this one is given to the activation function. So activation function, here it is the ReLU function. So the ReLU function is required to introduce the some non-linearity. Non-linearity is required because our convolution operation is the linear one. As it is linear one, and whenever we see the any object, that object may be the supposed table. So on that table may be placed in the any position, maybe the direction, maybe the change, its rotation may be changed, still we can identify this is a table. So there is the non-linearity. To introduce this non-linearity, we require the ReLU function. So output of each and every filter is processed through the this activation function as a ReLU. So convolution plus ReLU will form our convolution layer. After the convolution layer, there is the pooling layer. So there may be the different types of pooling, maybe the max pooling, maybe the average pooling, or minimum pooling. So various methods of the poolings are there. So this will be pooling layers are required to downsampling the resultant image. So it will be image will be again its size will be reduced than this one. So again it will be downsampled, and we are getting the very small size images in the pooling layer. So as the size of the image is goes on reducing, and because of that it will require the very less weight to process, as well as it will be used for avoiding the overfitting. So pooling layer is required for downsampling, as well as to avoid the it will help for avoiding the overfitting. So these two layers, convolution layer along with ReLU activation function, and pooling layer, additional one pooling layer, so these two pairs are repeated number of times. Why this required to repeat the number of times? Because here is convolution layer, pooling layer, after that again convolution layer, pooling layer, again you can use the convolution layer, pooling. So this pair of the convolution and the pooling layers, these are repeated number of times. So this repetition is required because initially the first pair of the pooling and the convolution will extract the some information, maybe the only the edges of the any object. Then after that, from this will become the small image. From that smaller one, again we want to extract the some more information or the specific information. Again repeat this part. Again, if you want to detect the specific information or the very critical information or the important information from that image, again repeat this one. So if you repeat this number of times, these two layers, definitely we are getting the very precise information from the any image. So it is normally first see the image as a whole, larger size, then to get the specific information from that image, come to the smaller size, focus on the very small portion or the small portion of that object, get the specific information. Again, if you want another specific information or the very critical information or the important information, again go for the very small size. In that way, you will get the very specific information from that particular object. Similar to this one, if you are initially, you can see the table as a whole. After that, if you want that, what is kept on the table, top of the table, so that object, whatever it may be, so that we can identify. So we have to go for the smaller portion, smaller things in the image. Again, within that object, something is book is kept on the table, so we can identify the book. If you want that, this what is written on the book, again go for the very smaller one. So in that way, it will initially it will see the image as a whole, larger one. After that, by repeating this convolution layer and the pulling layer, the image size will be goes on reducing. That means we are seeing the very critically or the very small portion of the image. So we are getting the more critical information from that image or the object. So how many number of times it has to be repeat, that depends upon the how much information, critical information or important information you require. After this, so anyway, output of this pulling layer, how many number of layers and all repetition we require, because this will give you the matrix, though it is a very small, but it will be n by n, n by m, or the m by n matrix, number of rows and number of columns. And this is given to the fully connected network. So this is the fully connected network for the classification. So what is, why it is fully connected? Because every node or every node of the previous layer is connected with the every node of the next layer, and because of that there are the large number of hidden layer node, and this will become as the very complex fully connected network. And input to this one is applied as a maybe the row wise or column wise. We cannot apply the matrix directly. So to conversion of matrix to the column wise we require, and that is done by this flattening. So flattening or the flattener or the flattened layer convert the matrix into the column wise. So one by one column of that matrix we can apply to the input for this fully connected network, which does the work of classification. And after that, so this is your fully connected network. And after that, we can use the certain softmax activation so that it will be classify the input image. So input image, maybe the suppose there are the two class images we are giving. If we are giving the suppose the cat as an input, so there are the two classes. So this class is for correspond to the cat, this another class output, it is corresponding to the dog suppose. So when you apply the cat as an input, so value of this node, output node, will be higher compared to this one, and we can say that the applied input is of the class category. If it is the dog, then the value of this node will be larger as compared to this one, first one. So we can say that the applied input is of the dog or the dog category. So in that way, this will classify the applied input. So features are extracted because of all this, and then classification is done by the neural network. So as a whole, this is called as the architecture of the CNN. So CNN does the both the work. It will extract the features by using the convolution operation, and then it will classify the input into the different categories or different classes by using the your neural network or the deep neural network, having the number of layers, hidden layers, as well as number of nodes. So this is your architecture of the CNN. Then we'll see the motivation. What is the motivation behind using this CNN for all these applications? By using the CNN on that convolution operation, basically, how the efficiency of the all these algorithm machine learning systems are goes on increase or increases with less number of connections. So for that, there are the three important ideas to improve the machine learning system. That is, the first one is the sparse interaction. How it is the interaction with the your weights or the kernel with the input image, and that is the sparse, not the full interaction. Then the parameter sharing, how the parameters are shared across the whole network, and by this we can increase the improve the accuracy or the improve the performance of the system. And equivariant representation. So all these three parameters we are going to see in the next slide. So this is the sparse connectivity due to image convolution. So when you use the convolution, basically it will sparse connectivity or sparse interaction between the kernel and the input image. So let us consider the input image may have the millions of the pixels. So in any input image has the very large number of pixels in number of rows, number of columns. But we can detect the edges with the kernel of the lower size, hundreds of pixels. So the kernel or the filters is having the very less number of pixels or the values of this one. Maybe the 3x3 having only the 9 values, or it may be the 5x5 or the 7x7. So in that way it is always the odd numbers. So with this 9 values or the 25 values, we can detect the edges of the image, given image. If we limit number of connections of the each input to k, so limiting the connection means limiting the number of values of the kernel or the filter. So maybe up to 9 or the 25, 5x5 or 3x3. We need the k by n parameters, and its runtime time complexity will be the big O of k into n. So it will be faster one. When you convolve this large image having the more number of pixel with the smaller kernel or the smaller filter. So its runtime complexity also remains big O of k into n, smaller one. It is possible to get the good performance with k is less than n. N is the size of the image and k is the size of filter or the kernel. So if kernel size is larger than the image size, we can improve the performance. That is because of all these things, sparse connectivity or the sparse interaction, and by using the convolution. Let us consider this image. The small portion of this image here, this is extracted view of this small portion. So here there are the black pixel as well as white pixel, black pixel, and these values of these pixels are the higher values for here. It is shown as for the black portion, smaller values 0 and 1 for smaller or the white portion, and again for the black it is a higher value, 10, 9, 8 something. Okay, so this is converted. So this is having the matrix. So this small portion only, this is extracted. So here the how it is performed, this is your image or the small image, actually some portion of the image having the values, pixel values, and this is your kernel or filter. So this filter is placed initially here. Actually here it is shown as the padding, zero padding for border columns and the border rows. Okay, so these are used of zero padding. So padding is used basically to keep the output size same. And if it is not used, in that case you cannot, if it is zero is not padded with this one. So original image is having only this one, this column, and this column up to this one. Okay, middle one. So this is the original image. So you have to put the this 3x3 kernel or 3x3 filter over this portion only. Okay, 3x3. And because of that, we are considering only this column, this particular pixel, which will be converted or transformed into the new pixel. But in that case, this pixel will be missed. So that the first row will be missed, some first column will be missed. And to avoid that, the resultant image size will be lower one. So to avoid that, we are using the here the zero padding and all. Okay. So this will be kept. So this is the kernel of 3x3 having certain values. So these values decide that what is the type of this filter. Okay. We are going to see this later on in the next video. What are the operations of the CNN? So this will be put here initially. This is convol means this 4 is multiplied with the 0 because this 4 will be comes over this one. The 0 will be multiplied with the 0 plus the 0 will be multiplied with the 0. This 0 will be multiplied with 0. 1 will be multiplied with the 0 in that way. So with this one, all will become 0. This will be become 0 whatever the value because it's multiplied with 0. Middle one is the already 0 and whatever the values here, still it will become 0 and remaining is only the 2 into minus 4. And that will be converted into minus 8. So these are the calculation given. So in that way, this 1 will be converted or transformed into the in new image as a minus 8. So then this will be moved by 1 column. Okay. So next it will be slided. That is called as the stride. How many number of pixel you are going to slide this? So it is slide by only the one if the stride is equals to 1. In that case we are considering this portion. The first column will be left. So next second, third and fourth column will be considered and these are the three rows. Okay. Again this will be put over here convol with this 9 original pixel and the middle one pixel will be converted into the new one here. So in that way it is slided one by one column and it will goes up to the last column. Then after that you have to consider the slide downward. So this will be covered with this one. So topmost row will be left out then. Okay. Then again move horizontally. Then again come to the one column or one row downward. So because stride is equals to 1 or the slide is equals to 1. That is called as the stride. Okay. So in that way we have to convol it with all the pixels. And we are getting the resultant image with convol with convolution or the with transformation. Okay. So convolution networks have the sparse interaction accomplished by making the kernel smaller than the input image. So kernel or this filter is of the smaller size as compared to image size, and because of this there is a sparse interaction, means at a time we are interacted with only this portion of at any instant of time. This kernel will be interacted with only this part. At another instant of time, it will be interacted only another 9 values of the pixel. At another instant of time, it will be interacted with another 9. So at a time, it will interacted with only the 9 pixels of the image. And there will be the interaction, the sparse interaction, not full interaction with the image simultaneously. That's why this is called as the sparse interaction. So this is something about the neural network for the 1D convolution. 1D convolution means having the time series only the one dimension. So these are the input x0 to x8, 9 inputs, and these are the weight. So kernel is of the one dimension again, from 0, 0 all the 0, 0 up to 8, and the middle one w1 and w0 only two values are there. So this w1 w2 is multiplied with x1 x0 and x1. And here it will be the added, and there may be the certain bias for this. This is the your you can say unit or the neuron. Then w0 will be multiplied with x1, w1 will be multiplied with x2, and sum of this one will be the here along with the addition of the some bias. So in that way we can get the output w0 to w7. So it will be repeated up to for the all the inputs and the weights. So we can write this in the equation form w0 x0 will be multiplied, w0 and x0 is multiplied plus w1 x1 minus b. So the bias is added. So a negative bias is given here. So we'll get the y0. Similar for the y1, sigma is nothing but the sum function, maybe the activation function of this is the net output or input of this particular neuron and its function. Maybe the your ReLU function or maybe the sigmoid function. So this is the activation function of the net value, what we have seen in the previous traditional network. So in that way it will be done for the all the output y0 to y7. we can write the equation in the form of element of the general wet matrix. Okay, so this W0, W1, then all others are 0, all others are 0, W0, W1, only W0 and W1, only two weights are there. But we can write this in terms of the matrix form, and then again it will be multiplied with the in the same way. But here is a two dimension matrix or the wet matrix, and because of that W0, W1 into X0. So W0, W1 means it is the W0, W0 means this will be multiplied with the X0. This will be the W01 because 0th row and the first column multiplied with the X1. Then in that way it will be goes on. So indirectly this will become 0 because all other weights are the 0 later on. So remaining only the W0 and W1, and these are multiplied with the X0 and X1. So it is the same as this one. So similarly for the other outputs. But if you use the matrix form, there will be, though these are the 0, but this has to be multiplied with the all inputs. Every time it will be multiplied with the all inputs. And because of that, there will be the large number of calculations. Or the, there will be the more number of calculations if you are using the matrix form. So convolution is more important, or the it is important in the direction of the computational complexity. So if you use the convolution, in that case the calculation will be less. That we'll see later on by using one example. So if you use the matrix form similar to your traditional neural network, in traditional neural network we are using the wet matrix, and there will be the input matrix, and then we are multiplying this each and every weight with the each and every input. So there will be the large number of computation in case of the traditional network, while when you use the convolution the computation complexity is less, so number of computations will be reduces. This gives you the sparse connectivity when you see it from the below means from the input. So highlight one input X3. So out of this number of input nodes, only the X3 is highlighted. Output units as affected by its, how many number of units in the output layer affected by the X3, these are highlighted. So three inputs. Top one, that is S, is formed by the convolution with the kernel of the weight 3. Only 3 outputs are affected by X3. So if you are using the kernel of 3, that is the 3 values, in that case X3 will be affected only the 3 output nodes, or the 3 nodes in the next layer if you are using the convolution. But if you use the your matrix multiplication in same similar to your traditional network, in that case this input, same input, will affect the all the nodes in the next layer. See this one, because this is connected to each and every node in the next layer. Every unit in the input layer is connected to the each and every node in the output layer, and because of that each and every node in the next layer than this layer will be gets affected by the any one input. If you consider the another input, this is also connected with all, and because of that all the nodes are gets affected or gets interacted with the that single node. This is not the case with the convolution. In convolution, any one input node in the any one previous layer will gets affect only the three node if you are using the kernel of the 3 in the next layer. So because of this one, so that's why it is called as the sparse connectivity or the interaction. Only small portion of the your network will be gets affected or the interacted, while in case of the matrix multiplication in your traditional network, everything will be gets affected, all the nodes in the next layer will be gets affected by the any one input in the previous node. If you see this from the above, that is from the output layer node to the input layer node, or the next layer to previous node. So in this case, this one node in the output layer or the next layer will affect the three nodes in the input layer, or you can say that the three nodes in the input layer will derive the output of only the one. So there is the sparse connectivity or the interaction between only this, while in case of the matrix multiplication, the single node in the next layer will be driven or will be affected by the output of all the nodes in the previous layer. And because of that, there will be large number of calculation if you are using the traditional network. And if you are using the convolution, only there is the small number of nodes or gets interacted. And because of that, the time complexity of the by using the convolution is low as compared to your traditional multiplication or matrix multiplication. But still, its performance is better. Though the interconnection is less, this is at a time. If you go for this one, it will be interacted with the another three. This one as well as this one. Okay. If you go for this node, input node, this will be interacted with this one, this one, this one. All nodes are covered, but not simultaneously. Only few number of nodes depends upon your dimension or the size of your kernel will be gets affected at a time. And that is the beauty of convolution. It is giving the first interaction. So still its performance is good with reduced connection or the less number of connection. It is possible to obtain a good performance while keeping the K several times lower than the M. Okay, so the size of the kernel is very smaller as compared to the size of the image. In deep neural network, units in deeper layers may indirectly interact with the larger portion of the input. See this. In case of the deeper network, what will happens? Though we are considering the at a time very small interaction, this will be interacted with only the three in the next layer. But if you are using the more number of layers in the deeper or the deep neural network, large number of hidden layers and all, so number of layers will be there. So the node in the one layer will interacted only with the three, but this three will be interacted with the another three in the next layer. So this will be interacted with this one as well as this one. This one will be again interacted with this, this and this. And this one will be interacted with this, this, this. So indirectly you can say that initially we are saying that this the node will be interacted with the very less number of node directly in the immediate next layer. But if you go for the more number of layers, so indirectly your first any one node will be indirectly interacted with all the nodes. And because of that, though the calculations are less level by or the layer by layer, or you can say by convolving the small portion with the input image at a time, very small number of pixels are considered. But indirectly, when you move this to the all the portions of the image, it will be interacted with all the nodes. And that is because of this one, its performance will be better. Okay, though there are the very less connections or the very less interaction in case of the convolution, but its performance will be better. That is because of this. Indirectly, it will interact with the all the input nodes. This allows the network to efficiently describe the complicated interaction between the many variables from simple building blocks that only describe the sparse interaction. So if you use the convolution, there are the very less number of interaction, but still it is possible to describe the complicated interaction between the many variables, that is the many inputs. But it will be the direct indirectly, not directly with the next layer. Okay. And because of that, its performance will be kept up or the high performance. Then the parameter sharing. So the another you can say why this are use motivation. So parameter sharing. Parameter sharing refers to using the same parameter for more than one function in the model. In traditional neural net, each element of the weight matrix is used exactly once when the computing the output of the layer. So when we are computing the output of any one neurons in the next layer, the inputs from all the input layers or input neurons are gets connected to that one. Okay, so it's used to exactly once. So all these weights are used exactly once in case of traditional network output of the layer. It is multiplied by one element of the input and never revisited. So once you calculate the output of that particular neuron by calculating W, I, X, I, all the inputs connected to that node you are getting the output of this node, and never we are going to visit this one. The parameter sharing is synonym is with tied weight. Tied weight means which are the weights connected to this particular node. Value of the weight applied to one input is tied to a weight applied elsewhere. So the one input, so there are number of inputs x1, x2, x3, x4. There are the number of nodes in the next layer. So one x1 is connected to the first node, and all other nodes from the all other inputs, these are connected to the other nodes. And because of that, value of the weights applied to one input is tied to a weight applied elsewhere. So wherever these are applied, other node, other inputs, so that will be goes to the elsewhere. In convolution net, so that is in your traditional network. In convolution net, each member of the kernel is used in every position of the input. Okay, so as we are convolving the small kernel with each and every pixel of the input, so what we are doing, small portion will be considered, that is 9 weights will be considered in case of the 3x3 kernel. Then the same thing will be convolved with the next 9, then again next 9. In that way, the small weights, this weights are remains as the 9, so that 9 weights will be convolved with the whole image one by one, step by step. And we have only the 9 weights. In case of this one traditional network, there are the number of weights, because each and every input node, or each and every node in the first layer, is gets connected with each and every node in the next layer. And because of that, there are the more number of weights are to be updated in case of the traditional network. While in the convolution, we have to update only the 9 weights, because the weights are only remains as the number is remains as the 9. And this will be take care of each and every portion at a time 9 pixels, and then it will be moved to the another 9 pixel. And because of that, so it will be cover each and everything, each and every part of the image, except at the boundary, subject to the design decision. So except the boundary, if you are not using the padding, we have to escape the boundary rows and the column. Efficiency of the parameter sharing. So if you share this parameter, the parameter sharing, so that's why it is called the parameter sharing, because that 9 weights are shared with all the pixels one by one. Parameter sharing by convolution operation means that rather than learning a separate set of parameters for every location, so in case of traditional one, what we are going for each and every input, there is the one weight for each and every node in the next layer. And there is a large number of weights. So each and every inputs, there is the one weight. So in for every location, we learn only one set. In case of the convolution, we have to learn only the one set, that is having only the 9 weights or the 9 values. Only that 9 values are goes on changing. This does not affect the runtime of forward propagation. So the its runtime time complexity will remain as the big O of k into n, but further reduce the storage requirement to k parameters. In case of your traditional one, as there are the many number of weights and many number of nodes, many number of weights, all the nodes and all the weights we have to save or the store. So large matrix, weight matrix we have to store. While in case of convolution, as there are only the 9 weights, we have to save only the 9 weights till all the complete procedure. And no doubt the values are changing, but the weights will be this number will be remains as the 9 weights only. And because of that, it will reduce as the storage requirement to the k parameters. K is the nothing but the size of your kernel or filter. Efficiency. This shows that this how the efficiency of the convolution for one application, edge detection by using the convolution, how it is higher than this matrix multiplication. Image on the right formed by taking the each pixel of the input image and subtracting the value of its neighboring pixel on the left. how this image is formed. This is the edge detected image from this original image. So this is formed by subtracting the previous pixel from the current pixel. So x minus n is subtracted from the x. Okay, so in that way it will be done, this operation will be done for the each and every pixel horizontally, and because of that we are getting this vertical edge of this image. If you want the horizontal edge, you have to subtract the vertically previous node subtracted from the current node. So in that way, so depends upon the which type of edge you want to detect. So it is for the vertical edge detection. So the previous node in horizontal fashion is subtracted from the current node, then this will be subtracted from the next node, this will be subtracted from the next node. In that way it will be go down considering the all the nodes in horizontal fashion. So definitely the number of nodes, number of pixel in the horizontal side or the width will be the less than one, okay, than this original image. So this is the measure of all vertically oriented edge. So it is a vertical edge detection. Both images are the 280 pixel tall, that is the height of this both the images are 280 pixel. So same size, vertical size is not changed because you are using the vertical edge detection and it will perform horizontally. Input image is 320 pixel wide. So this is the 320 pixel wide, width is 320 pixel. Output image is the 319 pixel. So one pixel less than the original image horizontally, that is the width is less than one pixel for the output image. That is because the current, to find out the current pixel, we have to subtract the previous pixel from the current one, then that one will be subtracted from the next one. In that way, for two subtraction we are getting the one pixel. Definitely the size horizontals or the width will be reduced by the one pixel. This transformation can be described by the convolution kernel containing the two element and requires the this many number of computation, 319, because there are the 319 number of pixel in the resultant one and the 320 number of pixels in the original image horizontally multiplied by 3, because this we are can be done by using the two element kernel. So that is the what will be the kernel, the horizontal only two, you can say this will be of this type having only two element. The first element will be minus 1 of this kernel and the next one will be the plus 1. Okay, so with this one we can horizontally multiply the each and every pixel. So minus 1 will be multiplied with this first one, 1 will be multiplied with the next one, and then there will be the subtraction or addition of this. So definitely the this previous pixel will be subtracted from the next pixel and this will be move over the horizontally or row wise, okay, on the complete row. And because of that there will be the three operation. Basically this will the multiplication of the one pixel, second one will be multiplication with another pixel, and then will be the addition or subtraction from this pixel will be subtracted from this pixel, next pixel. And because of that, so these two we required for the multiplication and one for the addition. So that's why it is the three here. So how many number of calculations we required, that is multiplication plus addition, that is the three for each and every pixel. And because of that, and this size of this image is 319 for this number of pixel horizontally and 320 for the original image. And because of that, this will be the number of calculation. The same if you use by the transformation, we require that the 320 by 280, that is the size of this first image, horizontal width is 320 pixel, vertical is 280 pixel, and for this one horizontal pixels are 319 and the vertical number or height is 280 pixel. So height is same for both. So you require that this is the one image and this is your output image. So this is input image size, output image size in terms of the rows and the column. So this will give you the 8 billion number of entries or the number of calculation. So convolution, so this part is the by the using the convolution, the same operation by using the convolution operation, okay. And same result if you required by using your transformation or the matrix multiplication, you require this many number of calculation. and because of that, this convolution is the 4 billion times more efficient. So these calculations are very less than this one, and because of that, this convolution operation for getting the any output by using the any filter, small filter, is very efficient in the direction of number of calculation or the computational complexity. So this is something about the one point in the motivation. Equivariance of convolution to translation. What is indicates? If your input, in case of input image, if there is the slight change, or we can say shifting of the any object. Okay, translation, that is the translation. What is the equivariance for the convolution when you perform the convolution and when you perform the translation? The particular form of parameter sharing leads to the equivariance to translation. Equivariance means that if the input changes, the output changes in the same way. If there is the shifting in the object in the input image, the same shifting will we are getting at the output. So that is called as the equivariance. So what is the change in the input in terms of the shifting? The same change will be observed in the output. A function f of x is equivalent to equivariant to function g. So g is the one function which we can use for the shifting or the translation, and f of x is the your convolution function. So these are the two functions. If f of g of x, so this is the convolution of translation, is equals to the translation of convolution, if both are equal, if the g is a function that translate the input, g is function translate the input, so that is the one operation, that is that shift it, then the convolution function is equivalent to g. So what we are doing by using the g translation function, so it will translate or the shift your object to the new position by using the g function. We are defining the g function such that your object in the image will be changed from one position to another position. So this is the shifting. X, y, so x and y is the location or the coordinates of that particular pixel. I is its intensity value. Is image brightness at point xy, so xy coordinates at that point, what is the brightness or the intensity, that is equals to I. I dash is equals to g of I. If you take the translation function, if you perform the translation function over the original image I, you are getting the I dash. Is the image function with I dash x, y, x comma y. So I dash is the x comma y, is equals to I x minus 1 comma y. Okay, what it does? We are performing the g function over the original image I, and while doing this one, we are taking the x minus y, that is the previous pixel in x direction, becomes as the x1. So same as the previous one. Previous one is subtracted from the current one. So x minus 1, that is the previous pixel in the x axis, will be becomes as the x. And the y will be, that is vertically we are keeping the same. So it is in the horizontal direction. So this y will be same. So we are getting the I dash, that is the shifting. So it will shift the every pixel of I one unit to the right. So it will be the right shifting of each and every pixel of that object in the x direction, that is in the right direction. So anyway, there is, if you perform this shifting or the any input image, so definitely what are the intensity values will be shifted by the one pixel to the right, and whole object you will see that it is shifted slightly to the right by one pixel. If you do this, if you want to shift them more, you can take it as the x minus 4, 5, 6, what it may be. So the whole object will be shifted by that many number of pixel in the right direction than the original image. If we apply the g to I and then apply the convolution, what we are doing? If you apply the g, so first do the apply the shifting operation and then apply the convolution over that shifting operation. So output of the shifting operation and over that we are applying the convolution. The output will be the same. Okay, so if you apply the first sifting and then convolution over that output, the output will be the same as if we applied the convolution to I dash, then applied the transformation G to the output. Okay, so what it indicates? If you apply the sifting operation first and then apply the convolution over the output of that sifting operation, the resultant or the output will be the same as if you apply the first convolution and then you apply the transformation or the sifting. So both the outputs are same, similar to this. So this is called as the equivalence. And because of that, the equivalence is important wherever you require that this which object you want to detect. So basically it is a location invariant method. So if your location of the any object is shifted anywhere in the image, still your this convolution method will get a better result. So there is no effect of the translation of the any object from one position to another position in the input image, and still your output will be better in case of the convolution operation. So this is something about the CNN. So what we have studied here, only important thing from your exam point of view, that is structure of the CNN or the architecture of CNN, their applications, and the explanation of the architecture. Okay, only these things. This part basically motivation and these 3 points. So these 3 points are not so much important for your exam point of view. These are for the further study. If you want to do the further study, then this motivation 3 points are very important. Okay, how it is important, how the performance will be better. You can read this so that you can explain very well your CNN architecture. Okay, so next video we'll see the what are the operations, right, from convolution, then max pooling. So all these operations we'll see in the next video. So thank you for watching this video.